ब्रह्मा शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। श्री चित घन गणेशाय नमो। यम सुकन नित्यम सुप्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्यम बुद्धिर्दर्क पारम सत्य वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहन्नमत्तो नित्य में निश्चिता मति ही। सो वी बिगिन द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर टुडे, सिक्स्थ तरंग। अतः गुरु वेदांतादि साधन मिथ्यात्व निर्णनम नाम षष्ठस्तरंगः। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज गुरु वेदांत एंड एवरीथिंग एल्स एंटायर प्रपंच विच इज दिस साधन ऑल दैट इज मिथ्या। वी हैव सीन प्रपंच मिथ्यात्व एनीवे, बट साधन मिथ्यात्व इज द स्पेसिफिक फोकस हियर। बट व्हाइल डिस्क्राइबिंग साधन ऑब्वियसली एवरीथिंग एल्स has to be talked about as mithya, and just like it was there in the fourth and fifth chapter, in sixth chapter also it will primarily cater to one type of adhikari and cover the others also. In passing, focus will be on a particular type of adhikari. The fourth taranga was committed to an uttama adhikari, the fifth to madhyama adhikari, and this one is for the adhama adhikari. But still, all three will be covered. Initially, in the fourth chapter, we saw that the eldest brother had very few questions. He had complete Shraddha in the Shastras. There were questions, but they were not many. There was no doubt about Shruti leading to Moksha. That was very clear to him, the eldest brother. The second brother had some questions. And then even after teaching by couple of prakriyas, including the fourth chapter, he was also Shrota in the fourth chapter, he did not get moksha. Therefore, dhyana was taught, whether saguna upasana or nirguna upasana. And then if one is a sannyasi, then assuming that he took sannyasa, omkara upasana, pranava ahangra upasana, or without pranava upasana also other upasanas, with ahangra upasana, one can get jnana here and moksha, or through karma mukti. So the earlier two brothers have attained jnana, so they are not questioning anymore. But the third brother who is here, who is tarka drishti, called as tarka drishti, he has questions. None of these prakriyas, jhanas have worked for him because he has so many questions. So having many questions shows not necessarily lack of Shraddha, but Tarka takes primary basis. Shraddha is there, but Shraddha is secondary. This is the case of almost everyone in the garb of Vedantins also, except Advaita Vedantin in the Darshana Shastra. If you look at Darshanas, comparing Darshanas, if you look at, everyone considers Tarka as their basis. Not only Tarkikas, Bauddhas also, Jainas also, Astika Darshanas also, Mimamsakas may not be so much dependent on Tarka, but still there is Tarka even in their analysis. In Mimamsa itself, textual analysis itself, some level of Tarka is there. But that can be due to, you know, basis of Vyakarana Shastra also. It is not only Tarka. And it is a mix of a little to analyze the text. But once they land on the text meaning proper, then they hold on to it in Karmakanda. And then they extend it to Vedanta also, where they cannot find any karma, they say it is Arthavada. So they have a process there. But if you look at others, the other darshanas which have popped up, calling themselves as Vedanta also, they are Tarkikas in the height of Vedanta. They are not really Vedantins, because primary pramana becomes Tarka. And this is the case of anyone, even an Advaitin, wanting to be an Advaitin, but still there are so many questions that come up. And therefore, a lot of obstacles are there. And those obstacles are indicatory of papa, obviously, because every obstacle is indicatory of papa. Even an obstacle for, I cannot sleep. I cannot sleep well, so I have to plug my ears. Sometimes I miss the alarm in the morning because I have plugged my ears, obviously. So if I don't plug my ears, I won't get sleep, which shows that prarabdha for the day is not over. So there is a lot of papa. And if I plug my ears, I can't wake up in time. I come late for the class. That is also samashti prarabdha here. Shows papa. Primarily mine, but then others also. So there is nothing wrong in saying that, yes, there is papa. So what? That's the reason I've been born as a human being. We can work towards it. We still have free will. We can work against it and correct the course. So tarka drishti also can get moksha. Although he is an adhamadhikari. Adhamadhikari just means that he needs more effort. That's all. And questions are to be answered. Shastra and Guru are there for the questions. As long as the questions are not, you know, of academic interest, they are focused towards one's moksha, all questions are valid and welcome. So based on that, this is the sixth chapter. Upodghata. So initially itself, there is a tippana. I'll cover the tippana later. It is just the definition of upodghata. Chaturtha tarange uttamadhikarinaha upadesha prakaro varnitaha. We saw this. Panchama tarange madhyamadhikarinaha upadesha prakara kathita. That also we saw. Asvinstu tarange kanishtadhikarinaha upadesha prakara nirupyate. So in this chapter, the focus, primary focus is the kanishta or the adhamadhikari. Yasya tu samshayaha bhavaha jayante sa tikshna buddhirapi kanishtadhikari eva bhavati. Just because the intellect is sharp does not make a person an uttamadhikari. This is a misunderstanding. Person starts to depend on one's buddhi more and more. The ego is boosted more and more as a person is more and more intellectual. So more intellectual person will likely fail in Shraddha. Not completely, but will start questioning the teachings of the Shruti and or the understanding of the Acharya based on the Shruti, including the Sampradaya, earlier Acharyas also. How can that be? Do others do not understand? Should we set our buddhi aside? No, you use your buddhi. If you are not convinced, then anyway, jnana is not going to take place just by Shraddha only. That Shraddha cannot be built up more and more unless one takes to other sadhanas. And one who is an intellectual cannot take to other sadhanas. If you ask the person to do bhajana, stotra, japa, ityadi, while as and when he is doing japa, dhyana, ityadi, there are questions popping up as to whether this dhyana is valid. Whether this japa is going to do something. How will this japa work? What exactly is the process in which this japa will connect to my chitta shuddhi? All these questions will come up and then shraddha being there also, it won't work. So might as well work on your questions and continue with your karma. So tikshna buddhi rapi yasya bhavaha samshayaha jayante saha kanishthadikari eva bhavati natu uttamava madhyamava adhikari bhavati samshayaha hi papatma. So samshayas are papas. Papatma is papas. Samshayatma vinashyati iti smritehe. So it is smriti. There is a smriti. This is the hetu for samshayatma vinashyati is the hetu for samshaya being due to papas. And that set of papas making a person a kanishta adhikari. And what is important, our focus should not be on, oh, do I have questions? We should not stop asking questions just because we will become a kanishta adhikari. Assume that when you start the path, assume that one ourselves, we should assume that we are kanishta adhikari. More the effort, more the fructification. So I should not be ashamed to call myself a kanishta adhikari because in that samasa itself, adhikari is sitting there. Irrelevant whether I am kanishta or jeshta bhrata. I am son of this person. If I take pride in my family, even if I don't take pride in my family, if whether I'm elder or younger is irrelevant. In the eyes of the parents, both are equal generally. So in the eyes of Ishwara also, everybody is equal. The difference is whether person will get moksha immediately or in time. But the guarantee is there that that moksha will definitely be there to each and every jiva as long as one becomes an adhikari. And here kanishta adhikari. Kanishtascha aso adhikari cha. So don't focus on kanishtatvam, focus on adhikaritvam. Tasya upadesha prakaro asmin tarange varnyate. Panchame. So what is the methodology? How that kind of a person should be taught? That is shown here. And the teaching is given appropriately. Panchame tarange pranavupasana jagad utpatti adi nirupana purvamidam uktam. So in the fifth chapter, pranava upasana jagad utpatyadi nirupanat, using dhyana as a tool, upasana, with pranava as the pratika, and jagad utpatti ityadi, all this nirupana was done. And tasmat purvamidam uktam, before that what was mentioned, chaitanyad bhinnam ajnanam tatkaryam cha anatma. Anything other than Chaitanya, what is that? Ajnana and Ajnana Karya. So, Atma, Anatma, Viveka is needed. Atma is Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya. Anatma is everything else. What is that everything else? It is Avidya and its Karya. So, Ajnana, Tatkaryancha, Anatma. Anatma Padartha Sarvapi Swapnavat Mithyaiti. And what was said, everything other than Atma is Mithya. Example for that, Swapna. Swapna Vat Mithya. Now if a person has understood this, one has, at least one has begun to see the Mithyatva in the Prapancha. Thereby, it is easy to walk out of samsara. Tam imam Guru Upadesham Shrutva Prashnadupurato Jeshto Vratharo Drushtva Tarka Drushtif Pruchati. This is taught to an Uttama Adhikari. Even a Madhyama Adhikari is not a single category. It is not that everyone in the Madhyama Adhikari category will be getting the moksha simultaneously. So Adrushti was an example there, who was also taught Swapnavat Mithya. Prapancha is sarva api anatma padartha swapnavat mithya. This was further explained in many ways, but all those dhyanas and other jagad utpatti, adhyaropa pavada, all those have led to understanding of this swapnavat mithyatam itself. Prapancha is mithya. This has to be understood. Without that, aikya jnana won't work. And having heard that upadesha, Prashnad Uparato Jeshto Bhrataro Drushtva. This Tarka Drushti, the third brother, youngest one, he looked at the other two brothers who were asking questions. So far, he was not asking so many questions. He was just listening to more qualified, you know, you delegate, you a group together, you say, you ask. So you know they are going to ask. So they both have asked valid questions. As long as the first brother was there, he was asking questions. He had very few questions. He was free. Then the second started asking his questions beyond the earlier's questions, or on top of them, or his own individual questions. Now, while listening to these questions, the second got mukti answers, listening to the answers of these questions. The third one started asking questions because now they are not asking questions. They are satisfied. You can't ask them to say, you can't hand over your questions. Why don't you ask these questions for me? So he has to ask his own questions now. Therefore, many of the people are like that. I also had that question. When someone asks, you say, I was also thinking whether or not to ask. Why don't you ask? At least ask when the others are not asking. So this is the case of Tarka Drishti. Having heard the teaching of the guru, the other two have got mukti. Now, Jeshto Bhrataro Drushtva, having seen them, this process is working for them. It may work for me also. So, let me ask questions. Therefore, Tarka Drushti Pruchati. What is his question? Kanishta Adhikarinaha Tarka Drushti Prashnaha. He is a Kanishta Adhikari. And what is his question? This Tarka Drushti's question. Swapna Drushtantena Jagrat Padartasya Mithyatun Nabhavati Iti Tarka Drushti Pruchati. Your example for Jagat Mithyatva is Swapna. Okay, Swapna is Mithya, but how is it that Swapna was Jagrat Mithya? How do you extend it to Jagrat Avastha? I did not understand. This does not seem appropriate. Na Bhavati, I am not able to see it. I can see Swapna as Mithya when I wake up. But how is it that in waking, I mean, you want me to see Prapancha is Mithya? How can it be? I am interacting. It is solid. You know, the way you say it's physical. It is not subtle. It is physical. When I touch Agni, it burns. How is it that it is Mithya? So these are all the, you know, confusions in his mind. And then he asks these questions. Purvam atyantam ajnyataha yaha padartaha tasya jnanam swapnena bhavati. So he is explaining his own understanding of swapna. What is swapna? And this is the understanding of many. And generally even Vedanta Acharyas teaches in this manner. What is swapna? In Jagrat Avastha, there is Anubhava. Those Anubhavas get accumulated because it is in Karma Ityadi, Upasana or Laukika Karma, Vaidika Karma, Upasanas. These will leave impressions on the Antakkarana. And this has happened across Janmas. These are there as Samskaras. These Samskaras or Vasanas are going to manifest as Ragadvesha in every state. Every state in a sense, whenever the mind is manifest, it will be manifest. So in Swapna and Jagrat Avastha, both will, in both the states, there will be manifestation of this Vasana, set of Vasanas. And generally, what do we say? Mostly, the dreams are where I can associate with the persons. Most of the time, the role play in the dream is the same character that I am playing in waking. Even if I don't accept it's a character, in Swapna it's a character at least. So here, whatever I am in waking, that is most of the case, that is my Swapna. I may be in different place, but I will be generally the same kind of person with same set of parents, same spouse and children. The family is kind of same. More or less same. Friends are more or less same. One off, I see something which is different. At least I don't remember whatever is different. That is also another argument one can make, because one keeps on dreaming a lot, does not remember. So what I remember is, at least what I remember is, a person, a dreamer, person is in dreamer me, is similar to the waker me. Therefore, what is the assumption, which even many teach as well, is that whatever was Anubhuta in Jagrat Avastha, that is also projected in dream. Something similar is projected. So I do not have any experiences in the dream, which I have not had in waking. So they are leftover kriyas, something which is unfinished business I dream about. So something of that sort is an explanation given for Swapna. Now this is what he is expressing. Purvam atyantam ajnata yaha padartha tasya jnanam swapne na bhavati. Whatever I have experienced, whatever I know about, that alone I have in dream. I do not have some other padartha coming up in dream which I have never had a vision of. I almost always know what, so I don't see Shashashrunga in dream. Purvam ajnata, in Jagrat Avastha it was not known. In Swapna I don't have, generally I don't see this kind of a thing. Whatever is Anubhuta, that is the Jnana in Swapna. Kintu Jagrati yad Vishayaka Anubhava Abhut Tad Vishayakam Smaranam Swapne Jayati. So Swapna is a memory of Jagrat Avastha. However, this is a misunderstanding. In this Grantha, it's elaborately explained as to why Swapna is not a Smarana of Jagrat Avastha. We have to understand technically what is Smarana, what is Smriti. So tad vishayakam smaranam swapne jayate is what Tarkadrishti is saying. Tathacha smriti vishaya jagrat padarthanam satyatvat swapne jayamanam tad vishayaka smriti jnanam api satyameva. So his data is invalid. His conclusion is invalid. But he is expressing that. Because he wants to learn. He knows that jnanena moksha, that much shraddha is there. And he has seen examples. He has seen his own brothers who have got moksha by a dialectic. So he knows it is possible. He has Shraddha in Shastra and Guru. So he is not ashamed to ask this question. He says, how is it that this Swapravat Mithyatvam you are teaching for Jagrat Avastha, Jagrat Prapancha, but Jagrat Prapancha is real. Swapna Padarthas are also real because it is a smriti of Jagrat. So he is flipping the argument. He says, Swapna Api Jagratvat Satyam. So Swapna Avastha is Satya, Swapna Padarthas are Satyas. Like Jagrat, not that Swapna is Mithya and therefore Jagrat is Mithya. It's the other way around. This is my understanding. Tasma Swapna Drishtantena Jagrat Padarthanam Mithyatva Katanam Na Yujyata Eva. Therefore, the teaching is not proper. He says it is not tenable. I don't see it logical. I see it the other way around. I think Swapnas are also Satya, and this is what Dvaitins have. The argument as Dvaitins say that Swapna is Ishwarakruta, just like Jagrat is Ishwarakruta, and it is all Satya. Swapno na Mithya. Before that, let's look at this. Chintam Prakruta Siddhyartham Upodghatam Vidurbudaha. So Chinta, what is that Chinta? Chinta, which is Prakruta Siddhyartham. Siddhyartham, because it is Siddhyartham, it may be Siddhyartham. Chintam Prakruta Siddhyartham seems more valid. Or Bahuri, you can say Chintam Prakruta Siddhyartham is Strilinga, because Chinta is Strilinga, is called as Upodghatam. So whatever is the context which is going to come up, in that context, I have to establish something, because something is Pratijnyata. Whatever is the Pratijnya, that has to be totaled up, summed up to conclusion as well. In between, I may take some detours here and there, and therefore, a summary of that, the inquiry which is going to be detailed later, but that inquiry in the beginning is called as Upodghata by those who know. Then Swapno Jagrati Anubhuta Padartha Vishayaka Smriti Rupa Manasa Viparyasa Iti Kachyatam Nayayikadinam Mataritya Ayam Prashnaha. So this question is based on the Nayayika's thinking. That is why he is Tarka Drishti. He knows how to ask questions. He has many questions. And his basis is logic. That is why he says, Na Yujyate Eva, does not look logical. That's the idea. Na Yujyate means what? Is not tenable. In my perspective, it is not tenable. I am not demeaning the Shastras or Guru, but I don't understand it. So logically, it does not seem valid to me. This is what his argument is. And Swapnaha Jagrati Anubhuta Padartha Vishayaka Smritihi. It is memory of the Jagrat Avastha Anubhavas. And what is this Smriti? Smriti Rupa. This Swapna is what? Is Manasa Vyapar, Manasa Viparyasa. It is some kind of a mental activity, modification of some vrittis based on Jagrat Anubhava. That is what Swapna is. Iti kathayatam nayyayikadina mataritya. The basis for this question analysis is Tarka Nayyayika Nyaya Shastra. That is how Tarka Drishti is asking the question. And the third point here was Smaranam, and then Linga Shariram. So anyway, we'll finish this Linga Shariram when we reach there. Swapno na Mithya. Swapna is not Mithya. Athava. Other way to ask the question is what? Swapna is not Mithya. Swapna Jnana Vishaya. Athava. Swapna Jnana Vishaya Bhutaha Padartha Satya Eva. All these Padarthas are Satya. Na Mithya. In Swapna also. How so? Tathahi. Swapna Avasthayam Stula Shariram Tyaktva Linga Shariram Bahir Nirgatya Sarvam Satyam Giri Samudradikam Pashyati. Ataha Swapno na Mithya. So in earlier case, Swapna is Satya because Swapna is a memory of the Jagrat Avastha Anubhava. जागृत अवस्था अनुभव इज ऑफ जागृत पदार्थ विचार सत्य देयरफॉर स्मृति ऑफ अ सत्य पदार्थ कैनॉट बी मिथ्या स्मृति ऑफ अ जागृत पदार्थ इज सत्य स्मृति देयरफॉर स्वप्न अवस्था बीइंग सत्य पदार्थ स्मृति जागृत अवस्था सत्य पदार्थ स्मृति देयरफॉर स्वप्न इज सत्य नाउ इन द सेकंड ऑप्शन व्हाई इज स्वप्न सत्य बिकॉज द स्वप्न इज नॉट स्मृति रूप अदर पॉसिबिलिटी व्हाई स्वप्न सत्य बिकॉज सूक्ष्म शरीर लिंग शरीर गोज आउट बहिर्निर्गत्य सर्वं सत्यं गिरि समुद्रादिकं पश्यति वॉट एवर यू हैव अनुभव ऑफ इन स्वप्न दैट इज ऑल्सो रियल बिकॉज सूक्ष्म शरीर इज ट्रेवलिंग आउटसाइड स्थूल शरीर मे बी स्लीपिंग बट सूक्ष्म शरीर इज ट्रेवलिंग आउटसाइड एंड इट इज हैविंग अनुभव सत्य पदार्थ इवन इन द वेकिंग स्टेट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग दिस सूक्ष्म शरीर हैज द वृत्तिज दिस इज व्हाट यू हैव एक्सप्लेन सो इफ यू हैव एक्सप्लेन दैट सूक्ष्म शरीर हैज अनुभव सूक्ष्म शरीर हैविंग अनुभव इन जागृत अवस्था हैज सत्य अनुभव बिकॉज द पदार्थ आर सत्य इन स्वप्न ऑल्सो पदार्थ आर सत्य बिकॉज द सूक्ष्म शरीर हैविंग अनुभव ऑफ सत्य पदार्थ नॉट मिथ्या पदार्थ द लिंग शरीर इज ट्रेवलिंग आउटसाइड सॉरी अतः स्वप्न न मिथ्या एंड व्हाट इज लिंग शरीरम पंच प्राण मनोबुद्धि दशेन्द्रिय समन्वित अपंचीकृत भूतोत्तम सूक्ष्मांगम भोग साधनम इट इज भोग साधन इन जागृत अवस्था ऑल्सो भोग साधन इन स्वप्न अवस्था ऑल्सो भोग साधन जस्ट बिकॉज आई हैड भोग इन स्वप्न यू कैनॉट से इट इज मिथ्या बिकॉज इन जागृत अवस्था ऑल्सो आई हैव भोग दिस सूक्ष्म अंग विच इज देयर व्हाट इज दैट The group of 10 indriyas along with pancha pranas, manas and buddhi. So 5 pranas, manas and buddhi, 17 with dasha indriya. Saptanga ekona vimshati mukha, said the Mandukya Upanishad. That is true in stula as well as, not stula, stula druk. True for stula druk in jagrata avastha also and this sukshma druk who is prayukta bhuk in swapna avastha also. Apanchikrita bhutottam, this sukshma sharira is a product of non-grossified 5 elements. But it is bhoga sadhana in jagrata avastha also and swapna avastha also. There is no difference. Padarthas anubhuta by सूक्ष्म शरीर इन दी स्वप्न अवस्था इज सेम एज जागृत अवस्था बट दी लिंग शरीर इज ट्रेवलिंग आउटसाइड इन स्वप्न देयर बाय इट इज हैविंग अनुभव इट इज ऑब्जेक्टिफाइंग रियल ऑब्जेक्ट्स आउटसाइड जस्ट लाइक इन जागृत अवस्था देयर फॉर स्वप्न इज नॉट मिथ्या सो इन बोथ वेज तर्कदृष्टि हैज एक्सप्लेन्ड दिस क्वेश्चन एज टू स्वप्न कैन नॉट बी मिथ्या इट इज सत्य पूर्वोक्त प्रश्न और उत्तरम व्हाट इज द आंसर टू द अर्लियर टू क्वेश्चंस स्वप्न ज्ञानम प्रत्यक्षम न जागृत पदार्थानां स्मृति रूपम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्वप्न ज्ञान इज प्रत्यक्ष इट इज नॉट स्मृति सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इनवैलिड व्हाई बिकॉज इट इज नॉट स्मृति रूप You have based your conclusion that Swapna is Satya because it is Smriti of Jagrat Padartha's Vichar Satya. Therefore, Smriti in the Swapna Avastha is Satya. Therefore, Swapna is Satya. Now, the rug is pulled saying that Swapna is not a recollection at all. It is not Smriti Rupa at all. So, your analysis that follows need not be answered. It is invalid. पूर्वकाल संबंधवतः पदार्थस्य ज्ञानं स्मृतिर्भवति व्हाई इज इट नॉट स्मृति बिकॉज व्हाट इज स्मृति पूर्वकाल संबंधवतः पदार्थस्य पदार्थ विच हैज पूर्वकाल संबंध नॉट करेंट काल व्हाट इज स्मृति इट इज एज गुड एज हैविंग अनुभव इट इज प्रत्यक्ष टू मी नॉट टू अदर्स बिकॉज एवरीबडी एल्स डू नॉट हैव access to my purva kala anubhuta padartha really they may having, or rather, let's not look at others. Let me look at myself. I have having anubhava right now of a padartha which is in this kala, that will be pratyaksha through chakshurindriya ityadi, or I may have this vritti which is not due to the chakshurindriya sambandha with the vishaya in this time. It may be in some other time. It may be I am looking at a person and I recollect how that person was 10 years back. Vritti is taking place in both cases, but the vritti is not due to the indriya sambandha with the vishaya right now in this kala. There is something that pops up in my antakarana as vritti based on how the person in front of me, the vishaya in front of me, was 10 years back. So the kala sambandha is different. So purva kala sambandha vata padarthasya jnanam smritir bhavati. So the vritti is of the padartha which has purva kala sambandha. It does not have current kala sambandha. So that vishaya is different really. That is smriti. That jnana is smriti. Yatha purvam drishtasya gajasya sah gajaha iti smriti rupam jnanam utpadyate. You saw an elephant and then you saw another elephant. It triggers the memory. You say, oh, I have seen this elephant earlier. This or whatever. I've seen an elephant earlier. I know. Puratasthitam gajam drishtvatu ayam gajah iti jayamanam jnanam tu na smritihi. If the person sees one elephant in front, you know, you're looking at an elephant, there you don't say, oh, I have seen the elephant. This is the earlier elephant. When you say this, when you're saying this, even if you say this is an earlier elephant, which I have seen, the same elephant or another elephant, however you say it, you say, ayam gajaha, this is an elephant. That is the vritti. This is an elephant. So, ayam gajaha iti jayamanam jnanam tu na smritihi, because ayam shows this kala sambandha, current kala sambandha, ayam, right in front of you. Idam, it is masculine of idam. So, that is not smriti. Kintu pratyaksham eva, that is pratyaksha. Clearly, there is no argument there. Chakshu goes to the Chakshur Indriya, drags the Antakkarana and goes to the Gaja. And then you say, I am Gaja, because there is Phale Vyapti after Vritti Vyapti. So, apne I am Gajaha Agre Tishtati, Iyam Nadi Prachim Disham Pravahati, Ayam Parvataha Ramyo Virajate, Ityam Jnanam Bhavati. So, when you have I am Gajaha Jnana in Jagrata Avastha, there it is Pratyaksha. In Swapna, do you say, oh, I recollect something that I have seen in waking state? No, the dreamer says, I am Gajaha. Just like the Jagrata Avastha waker says, I am Gajaha. So in waking, if you say, I am Gajaha, it is Pratyaksha, it is not Smriti. In Swapna also, Swapne, I am Gajaha, Agre Tishtati. If you look at a Gaja in front of you, you are going to run away. When will you not run away? When you are recollecting the Gaja. If you have seen an elephant earlier, let's say you are roaming around in the forest or whatever, and then you saw an elephant, obviously you will keep your distance. If you are close, you will run away. But when you recollect the elephant, you won't run away. You don't run away when you recollect the elephant. Just by recollection, if you see something like a snake, instead of rope, if you see snake there, then you run away. That is not smriti, because you don't know it as smriti. When you know it as smriti, you don't make a mistake and say that this is a snake. You recollect a snake. Similarly, you recollect a gajaha. When you recollect a gaja, you don't say this is an elephant, because nobody knows this. Everybody who knows this is having this kala sambandha. It is right in front of you. That is ayam, idam. But when you say ayam gajaha, it cannot be smriti. And when you have smriti, you cannot say I am Gajaha. You cannot run away from a remembered elephant or snake, etc. You cannot run towards an imagined, recollected silver, etc. Therefore, when you say I am Gajaha, you cannot say it is smriti. Sapne I am Gajaha agre tishtati. One who is the dreamer who sees the elephant in dream, he says, I am Gajaha Agre Tishtati. This is a vritti. Whether he says it or not, he knows that, oh, there is an elephant. This is an elephant right in front of me. What should I do? And then he looks at the river. He thinks, Iyam Nadi Prachim Disham Pravahati. It is flowing in this direction. Ayam Parvata Ramyo Virajati. Look at the beauty of the mountain. Which mountain? Pratyaksha mountain. Not remembered. Oh, in waking state, I had seen some. Or he does not know waking state, it's all right. Oh, I recollect the mountain. That is not the Anubhava. The Anubhava is, in front of me, there is a Parvata. Ityam Jnanam Bhavati. That Jnana cannot be Smriti. Tasma Jagrati Drashtanam Padarthanam Smaranam Naswapne Bhavati. Hintu Gajadinam Pratyaksha Jnanam Eva Bhavati. Whatever you see in Swapna, to the dreamer, it is Pratyaksha. What kind of Pratyaksha is irrelevant right now? Right now, we want to focus on whether or not it is a Smriti. It is not a Smriti. Kincha Yaduktam Jagrati Anubhuta Padartha Visheka Jnanam Eva Swapne Bhavati. Na Ananubhuta Padartha Visheka Jnanam Jayate Tasma Jagrat Padartha Jnana Janya Samskara Swapna Jnanam Udeti Samskara Janyam Jnanam Smriti Riti Kachyate Iti. All that is wrong. What was said as Jagrati Anubhuta Padartha Visheka Jnanam Swapne Bhavati. In the Swapnavastha, there is only recollected Padartha, recollected from Jagradavastha. Whatever has been Anubhuta, experienced in Jagradavastha, that is recollected. That knowledge comes about in dream, not something which is not experienced. It has to be experienced in the Jagradavastha. This is refuted in Mandukya Upanishad also. In fact, the waking state. Waking state Anubhava is also, Padartha is also, the seed and the sapling. When that analysis is done, there it is refuted as the seed or whatever is the earlier Anubhava leading to the next one, which you think is cyclical. There also the earlier need not be real. The vasanas need not be from the real Anubhava. They can be from the fake Anubhavas also. Anyway, I am taking a detour. That is just something which is going to be landed upon later. So, na ananubhuta padartha visheka jnanam jayate swapne. In swapna, you cannot have anubhava of something you have never experienced. That is not true. On a mass scale, when you say that, yes. But even one anubhava of something which is not experienced by me ever will break that rule. It is not a rule at all. Tasmat Jagrat Padartha Jnana Janya Samskara Swapna Jnanam Udeti. That kind of analysis you have done has no basis. Samskara Janyam Jnanam Smriti Riti Kathyate Iti. Tanna Yujyate. That is invalid. Your analysis that followed this is all wrong. Why? Tathahi Pratyaksha Jnanam Dvividham. Pratyaksha is of two types. So what kind of Pratyaksha is there in Jagrat Avastha? What kind of Pratyaksha is there in Swapna Avastha? This is the analysis now. It is not Smriti. It is Pratyaksha. If it is Pratyaksha, what is the difference between Jagrat Pratyaksha and Swapna Pratyaksha? Pratyaksha Jnanam Dvividham. Ekam Abhijna Rupa Pratyaksham Aparancha Pratyabhijna Rupa Pratyaksham Iti. So one is Abhijna Rupa Pratyaksham. Another is Pratyabhijna Rupa Pratyaksham. So in the other, Prati Upasarga is additional. So Abhijna Rupa Pratyaksha or Prati plus Abhijna. So Pratyabhijna Rupa Pratyaksha. There are two types of Pratyaksha Jnanas. What is the difference between the two? Kevalam Indriya Sannikarsha Janyam Jnanam Abhijna Pratyaksham Iti Varnyate. The Abhijna Pratyaksha Jnana is that which is Kevala Indriya Sannikarsha Janyam. When there is nothing else but Indriya connects with another Vishaya, with a Vishaya. When Indriya has connection with a Vishaya, the Pratyaksha Jnana will take place. When the Pramana and the Prameya comes together, there is no way that Jnana won't take place. When the Jnaya and the let's say pramana. Pramana and the prameya comes together, then the prama has to take place. Jnana has to take place. That is pratyaksha. So when the indriya is the pramana and vishaya is prameya, when there is sannikarsha, when they are in close proximity, in the sense, if it is eyes, then they are basically indriya gochara padartha. If the pramana is for that particular vishaya and it is in close proximity in such a way that it can reach and it is reaching, then the jnana prama will definitely take place. Assuming that nothing else is, you know, there are no obstacles. Because we are all saying that it is reaching. So in the case of eyesight, if there is a line of vision and the vishaya is in the line of vision, there is sannikarsha between the chakshurindriya and the ghata, then ghata jnana will take place. Similarly, if shabda is loud enough and my ears are reaching there, ears and my shrutrendriya is reaching there, the shabda jnana will take place. And so on with each and every indriya. That is what kind of pratyaksha. Nothing else is expected. So kevalam indriya sannikarsha janyam jnanam. That jnana is born out of connection of the pramana and the prameya. Pramana being indriya. So indriya and the vishaya connection leading to jnana is pratyaksha jnana. That jnana is pratyaksha jnana, which is called as abhijna pratyaksha. Which kind of pratyaksha? Abhijna pratyaksha. Yatha ayam gajaha. When you say ayam gajaha, then the chakshurindriya, netrendriya. So iti netrendriya sannikarsham matra janyam gajajnanam abhijna pratyaksham. So ayam gajaha, that jnana is by looking at the elephant using my eyes. So my eyes are connected to the gaja. Therefore, ayam gaja jnana is abhijna pratyaksha jnana. So, gaja jnana is abhijna pratyaksha in the case of ayam gaja. What about pratyabhijna pratyaksha? The definition given is purva anubhava janya samskarena indriya sannikarshena cha utpannam jnanam pratyabhijna pratyaksham iti varnyate. What is pratyabhijna pratyaksham? It is also pratyaksham. It is also pratyaksha jnana. But what kind of pratyaksha jnana? Purva anubhava janya samskarena indriya sannikarshena cha. So not only kevala indriya sannikarsha is there, but jnana is udbhuta with indriya sannikarsha as well as purva anubhava janya samskara. There are two factors in that is called as pratyabhijna. So there is past data also. In the current anubhava, past data is mixed up in some way. So there is indriya and the vishaya sannikarsha. On top of it, there is purva anubhava janya samskara also. That is called a pratyabhijna pratyaksham. Yatha purva anubhute gaja. We look at this tippana after this point because it is a little technical. I don't want to go into details and confuse. So if you understand this, the tippana can be ignored. I'll just read it for completion and I'll see how much I can explain. It is a little too much of detail. And without tarka, Tarka background is a little tricky to understand. Yatha purvanubhute gaje puratha drishte sati soyam gajaha iti jnanam pratyabhijna pratyaksham. So when you say ayam gajaha, it is pratyaksha, abhijna pratyaksha. When you say soyam gaja, it is also pratyaksha, but it is pratyabhijna pratyaksha. Because you are recollecting some gaja from earlier and you are saying that this is the same gaja that I am seeing now. Atra cha purva drishta hasti jnana janya samskara gajena sa netrendriya sambandha cha iti ubhayam api pratyabhijna pratyaksha karanam. So what is the karana for pratyabhijna pratyaksha jnana? In this case of when I say soyam gajaha, soyam devadatta, that example is soyam gajaha. Pura drishta hasti jnana janya samskaraha. So earlier hasti jnana, gaja jnana has left a samskara. Hasti is a gaja. So purvadrishta gajajnana janya samskara and gajena saha netrendriya sambandha cha. There is indriya sambandha, chakshurindriya sambandha with the gaja, and there is earlier anubhava of gaja when it was प्रत्यक्ष बोथ आर इति उभयम अपि प्रत्यभिज्ञा प्रत्यक्ष कारणम दे बोथ आर कारण फॉर प्रत्यभिज्ञा प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान अतश्च संस्कार जन्यम ज्ञानो स्मृतिरेव इति न नियमः नाउ ही सेज संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान इज स्मृति देयर इज नो सच नियम बिकॉज स्मृति डेफिनेशन इज ऑल्सो डिफरेंट विल सी दैट प्रत्यभिज्ञा प्रत्यक्षस्यापि संस्कार जन्यत्वात् वाय इफ संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान इज स्मृति देन देयर इज अतिव्याप्ति इनफैक्ट दैट इज व्हाट इज सेड इन द टिप्पण इफ यू से संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान इज स्मृति एंड दिस इज व्हाट यू आर सेइंग दैट स्वप्नावस्था इज जागृत संस्कार जन्य देयरफॉर यू से जागृत स्मृति जन्य स्वप्न स्वप्न इज नॉट स्मृति जन्य जागृत स्मृति जन्य वाय बिकॉज योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ स्मृति इज संस्कार जन्य इज दी स्वप्न ड्यू टू जागृत संस्कार मे बी मे नॉट बी बट इफ यू से इट इज संस्कार जन्य जागृत संस्कार जन्य यू कैनॉट से इट इज स्मृति जागृत संस्कार जन्य एनी संस्कार जन्य डज नॉट मेक इट स्मृति एट ऑल बिकॉज स्मृति डेफिनेशन इज इनकम्प्लीट इफ यू डिफाइन स्मृति एज जागृत संस्कार जन्य एनी संस्कार जन्य नॉट जागृत संस्कार जन्य एवरी संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान इफ इट इज स्मृति देन सोयम गजह इज अ स्मृति वाय बिकॉज सोयम गजह इन दैट सह व्हेन यू आर से सह अयम गजह सह गजह दैट सह गजह इज वॉट इट इज पूर्व काल संबंध देर इज सम पूर्व काल संबंध इज देर यू आर रिकॉलिंग समथिंग व्हेन यू से सह दैट गजह दैट आई सॉ और सोयम देवदत्त इन दैट एग्जाम्पल ऑल्सो दैट देवदत्त विच आई हैव सीन 10 इयर्स बैक इज दिस देवदत्त राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी व्हेन यू से सह अयम देवदत्त देर पूर्व संस्कार इज देर पूर्वदृष्ट देवदत्त संस्कार इज देर इज दैट स्मृति नो दिस प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान आई एम लुकिंग एट देवदत्त राइट नाउ सो इट इज प्रत्यक्ष इट इज नॉट स्मृति अदरवाइज दैट सोयम देवदत्त विल ऑल्सो बिकम अ स्मृति एंड इफ दैट इज द केस सो अहम ब्रह्म ऑल्सो तत्वमसि विल बिकम स्मृति दैट इज नॉट स्मृति इट इज प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण सिद्ध दैट इज वाई इट इज साक्षात्कार You cannot say smriti sakshatkara. There is no meaning to smriti sakshatkara. So samskara janyatvam is one thing. Smriti is not necessarily only samskara janya. Meaning every samskara janya is not smriti. Smriti is samskara janya, but everything that is samskara janya is not smriti. Therefore, jagrat, even swapna avastha, even if it is samskara janya, jagrat samskara janya, it need not be smriti. परंतु इंद्रिय सन्निकर्षम अंतर केवल संस्कार जन्यम ज्ञानम स्मृति ज्ञानम इति कीर्त्यति सो इफ यू से संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान स्मृति देन इट हैज अतिव्याप्ति इन प्रत्यभिज्ञा प्रत्यक्ष अतिव्याप्ति मीन्स द डेफिनेशन इज ब्रॉड इट इज कवरिंग प्रत्यभिज्ञा ऑल्सो इट शुड नॉट बी कवरिंग प्रत्यभिज्ञा प्रत्यक्ष विच इज एक्सप्लेन अर्लियर एज सोयम गजह एज एन एग्जाम्पल Soyam Gaja is not a Smriti. Therefore, your definition of Smriti, which is Samskara Janyatvam, that is invalid because it has extended itself and it covers Pratyabhijna also. It should cover only Smriti. It should not cover anything else. So this is Nayayika's way of defining, which is agreeable to everyone. Whenever you define something, that definition should not be broad enough to cover something which is not the intention of the definition, which is not the goal of the definition. It should fit perfectly in such a sense that it should cover the everything that you want to cover. It should not cover anything more. It should not cover anything less. So you cannot say that everything that is brown is a cow. Everything that has 4 feet is a cow. You cannot say that. It covers all cows, but it covers dogs also. It covers horses also. It covers other four-legged animals. So four-legged animals are not the goal. Only the cow is the goal. So your definition cannot be broad. Therefore, indriya sannikarsham antara kevala samskara janyam jnanam smriti. What is the real definition of smriti? It is that jnana which is kevala samskara janya. And what is kevala samskara janya? Which is also indriya sannikarsham antara. Without the indriya sannikarsha, without the connection of the indriya with the vishaya, that samskara which is leading to jnana, that is smriti. In the swapnavastha, you do not have this kind of smriti. Why? Because there is indriya sannikarsha. If there is no indriya sannikarsha, you won't say I am gajaha. So indriya sannikarsha is there in swapnavastha, therefore it is not smriti. We'll stop here. We'll go a little slow because this is a complex section. It is complex because the questions are complex. Answers will also be as complex because everything that is prodded by logic has to be answered logically. You cannot say, no, Shruti says it. You cannot say, no, I don't think so. So it is not like, you know, objection. Objection, my lord, and he says that overruled. It cannot be overruled. You have to give an answer. And that answer has to be in keeping with the question. It has to be in keeping with the Shishya's approach. Therefore, it has to take the logical approach. So this chapter is going to be complex in most parts because Tarka will be there. The Tippana will be more complex, but we'll try to see what we can do in Tippana. As much as we can do, I'll try. So let's see. Sukhan Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Namurupe Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhyer Dhritya Param Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramah Tadeva Annamattu Niti Me Nishchitamatihi. Any questions? So if you do not understand what is taught in that class, at least ask me in the next or WhatsApp, whatever you think is appropriate. Because if we don't understand the earlier, then the argument that follows may not set in. Okay. Venkateshi, did you have a question?
No, Pravinji. I had a smriti of our Tarka Sangraha class. That's all. That's all.
We'll see when we reach there. As I said, that we'll walk the bridge when we reach there.
Just that, and by my hand by mistake unmuted the.
No, that's okay. Yeah, that's okay. So, okay. So, if no questions, I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.